Obsessed with the idea of death, the idea that I was going to die. hungry, wake up screaming from some terrible dream and say, hey, I'm gonna die. I'm not gonna die, not ever. I promise.
She borrows things. I don't mind. Well, I do. A bit. Not really. You know, but she's always wanted to wear my clothes. Her brother was the same. The high heels, flip-flop shoes they call them. But that's normal, isn't it? Kids like to dress up, don't they? But now it's different. At least it seems different. I mean, there's still an element of dressing up, but she'll try things on her mind, and she'll look in the mirror and the way she looks, oh, it's cold. So critical. And part of me thinks, good for you. Not trying to kid yourself. Not making that mistake. But then part of me thinks, don't be so hard on yourself. Don't be so hard on me.
There's a sense, I suppose, of a clock ticking fast once a ball. You become self-conscious all the time, all these things you won't ever get to do again. First words, first steps. It feels so precious.
You've got to, you'll just keep up with that.
I think that's why you take all of them pictures. It all feels so sort of fleeting. I don't know, I guess it flattens out a bit in the middle.
True. Relax a bit. Life settles down.
And then all of a sudden, it's out of line. He sometimes talks about the years until he leaves, and if I'm honest, I feel at sea, if I'm honest. I feel...
This is the worst it's ever been. Actually, the other day I just went in and said, okay, I've done all I could do. From now on, it's on you. That's it. It's on you. When the results come out on the 23rd of August and you've not got enough to stay in on the 6th form, it's all on you. Of course, it's impossible if Dad basically left school with nothing but a cycling badge. So he says, he'll be alright. And it makes me so angry because you don't know that. You don't know that. And then I think, why do I always have to be the bloody bad guy all the time? Why is it always me?
The most important thing is, let know you get things wrong. Admit to your mistakes. Don't try and keep them right. Because, you see, anyway, our parents didn't do that. They belong to a generation that forced them to be untouchable, or at any rate. No way my kids think of me like that. They've seen me mess up too often. They've seen me mess up too many times.
I used to go on the train all the time and say to my parents, I don't know what time we're back. I'm going on train. Good for the run arrival now. I was a lot worse back then. But I used to go all over, as far as I could afford. Sometimes all the way to Preston. My parents didn't know what county I was in.
Okay. I mean, I find the hype thing difficult. If you'd have told me yesterday that one day, I'd probably have laughed in your face, but it matters. It just does. I mean, I've always been tall, but I'm not used to looking up at anybody. I mean, never mind my own son.
Kira's been quite slow returning texts. I try not to bug her so I get more of a response. But I say to her, I don't care where you are, or who you're with, or what you're doing, I just want you to be safe. You're all I care about. Be safe.
Get up! Come on, we've got some messages.
The last time you just go to bed!
Go out! Go on! Get some
fresh air! I want you back in this house! Bye!
What are you not still doing, Ma?
I haven't even started yet.
You need to eat something!
Who has eaten all this? You need to work harder!
You wear yourself out.
You've got to take it seriously.
Hey, it's not the end of the world.
Blah, 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 blah.
I hear myself, you know, and I just
and battered. They never feared that immediate reprisal. I've had to really look for ways to punish them. Honestly, if we don't hit them, I know some people do, that's their business. Because we don't, the question is, what can you do? I said to Jasmine, it's always Jasmine, after the last incident, okay, here's the deal. You know I'm on Lexi time, so that means I can choose my work hours. Let me tell you this, if you continue this behaviour, even if you are 15 years old, I will walk to school every morning and collect you every afternoon. I really mean it. That worked.
He's got a girlfriend. He goes to her house all the time. Every day, straight from school. And she seems very nice, but... Well, this is the trouble. We never know what time he's coming home. We say we only need a bit of communication. Just return our text. But he doesn't even have his phone switched on when he's around there.
You can remember things about yourself at that age. That's what makes it hard, I think.
In the end, I rang her dad and said, look, we really appreciate having Aaron so often, but could you please tell him to keep his phone switched on? And it would be great that when it got to 9:30, you'd send him home.
You can't remember your own first tooth. Or learning to read.
Of course not. But you're a teenager. You can remember that.
All levels. Kissing.
Well, when he found out, he went mad. I can't believe you did this. You showed me up so bad. On and on. Completely out of control.
I remember the taste of boys who smoked, and I never want my kids to smoke.
Of course I don't.
Or their friends, but to be 15 and kiss a boy who tastes of smoke.
It knocks his socks off. You made me look like a complete idiot. It's so embarrassing. I said, no! What's embarrassing is this. You, right now, you're embarrassing yourself. He said it's different. There's no one here to see. I said, I'm here, aren't I? He looked astonished, as though the thought had never occurred to him. Well, if I can't embarrass myself in front of my own mother, then what's the use of anything?
My own mother? He said that?
And I was thrilled because I'm always waiting for that whole thing to kick in. You're not my real mother. I'm always waiting for that.
For my 18th birthday, my parents bought me a set of suitcases. They said it was traditional. And when I did leave home, they did this thing where, I mean, straight away, they decorated completely everywhere. And then they started going on these really different holidays. I was so wounded. I just couldn't believe it.
He got bored.
Zach did. They all do. The boys, that is.
It's as if there's a little window of opportunity for these bigger boys to pounce. Like when crabs shed their shells and the birds are just waiting.
A man stood in front of me. He told me to give my bike to him.
Some of the bigger boys walked up to him, and his friends, broad daylight, you know.
This boy asked me the time, so I took out my phone.
Put everything in their pockets, just let them. Probably lose face, make a fuss.
I said, good boy, some things aren't worth fighting over.
She's not fat, I'll say that straight off. But she's not thin either. Not like some of the skinny, skinny girls that you see. I tell her, it doesn't matter. At your age, your body's changing all the time. And the way a person looks is a very small part of who they really are. I can tell she doesn't believe me. I don't believe myself sometimes, but it's what you're meant to say. My husband used to tell me I was beautiful. And I think, what are you? A liar? Or just stupid? In the end, it made me hate him.
We're a tight little unit. We've not had much choice since their dad got the picture. So when I was diagnosed, I just told them. I had a test that said I needed an operation. And the operation would be in 10 days' time. I told them I wasn't going to die. I felt pretty confident about that. He caught it very early, and my doctor seems really positive. So I told him that. It seemed important just to say it. I asked them to figure down any questions they wanted me to ask the doctor, because I had lots of questions too. And if we pooled our questions together, we might understand the illness better. Zach didn't ask anything. Nadia asked two things. What clue's the tumour? And after they take it out, can I have it?
He hates me at the moment. He really hates me. I look on his computer. He was a problem for a while with what he was watching. I had to talk to him about it. I had to tell him, this is nothing like that's not what real women look like. We're not enjoying it. They're probably just doing it to fund a drug habit or to feed their children. I checked his internet history and said, if you've cleared it, I'll just assume that's what you were looking at. And we'll be having this conversation again.
So one day, last summer, she came home in a rare old state. This is Jasmine again. I'll just say, she can't even read to get words out. They've been caught shoplifting. Darcy and Jenny Rose. I knew they were going to do it, so I went next door to Boots. It was a proper saga. Parents down to the police station, and the girls about to pay H&M. It's all that happened to me. But I had to have a talk with Jasmine. I had to say, all right, let me tell you. If you had been caught, it wouldn't have been the same. It would have been a completely different outcome. And here's why. Because you're from the estate. You need to learn this lesson. You'd have been treated completely differently. You always will be.
I know I'm pardoning, but he thinks I'm pardoning. But sometimes you just have to draw the line. I'm not always sure where the line is.
I called the meeting in Costa with the other mums. I said, I'm sorry. I really like your girls. When they're all together, when my daughter's with them, the thing that goes wrong. So my daughter will no longer be coming to your house, and your children are no longer welcome at my home. I never regretted that. You want them to learn lessons. The actions have consequences. They have to be hard lessons.
Our lives, but we had boys. They knew it. Killed them. Drugs, for example. We just about taking everything. I don't think it does any harm. But that's not a behaviour I approve of. I think it's dangerous behaviour.
I'm deliberate. Don't ask anymore. Whose is this? Whose is that? How long have you known them? What are you doing? The truth is, there's a distance between us. And I quite like that. I mean, we respect each other's boundaries. Like once, in the kitchen, I found a lighter. I just left it there. And like, magic, it disappeared. That's my policy, really. Do nothing. Things tend to sort themselves out. Still don't know how life belongs to.
If I'm honest, I've noticed myself competing with him a lot more. I mean, we always used to go down the park, you know, run races and play games, but recently I've noticed myself making the distances shorter and shorter. So I can still beat him.
I like to think he still needs me. I don't know if it's true. You know, sometimes me for a live, and actually, he's just being lazy. But I go, and I'm glad I go. Because how many more chances will there be? Thanks, Daddy says. But I'm not doing it for him. Doing it for me. You seem to think more about my dad now. You seem to think more about your parents as you get older. When they're not around anymore.
Get up! Come on! You're gonna miss it!
Oh, for the last time, can you just go to bed?
Go out! Go on! I want you back in this house! Bye!
Oh, you're not still doing that. Haven't you even started yet?
You need to eat something!
Who is eating, Ollie? You need to work harder!
You'll wear yourself out.
You've got to take it seriously! He can remember it, that line. Of course, he'll never forget it, but he keeps it to himself. He still hasn't called. Sometimes I think if I did to him what he just does to us, kept him hanging in the dark, his world would just collapse.
Once or twice I've admitted something that I've got wrong around about the rage. They're shocked. They can't handle it. They think they know everything about you, and you're the one thing in their world that they know everything about. It doesn't change. It's a compute when you do stuff doesn't go with that. I think they want you to lie. They lie too, of course. I guess that's how we all protect each other.
Once, when I was young. 17 it was. I got some out of club. I had a bad reaction to it. Had a classic bad trip. I was terrified. Utterly. Completely out of my depth. It could end really badly. But no way I was going to call my parents. So, this is what I said to my...
Ever out anyone can show about or you like what's going on. I don't care what it is. Drugs, girls, police. It doesn't matter. You call me, I will judge you. Anytime, day or night. Just call me and I'll sign up for you.
I asked him how to get me to play the iPod through the speakers. All he did was laugh in my face. He did it so fast that I couldn't see how to do it. Guess I'm just gonna have to ask him again to do it next time.
When I was growing up, all I wanted was to get away. It wasn't that I didn't love my parents, but I hated the whole extended family thing you get in immigrant communities. I needed to get out, get on. I know they've got to separate you from you, but I can't bear the idea of slowly drifting away.
She's not getting on with her mum. Occasionally there's little glimmers of bonding. But then her age was throats. And I'm the mediator. I try not to lose my temper. Even though I had a temper until we had Vera. She's quite a forceful character though. Like, when she was two, I'd use hostile negotiation techniques on her, and she still made mincemeat out of me. But a mum can't do anything right. She just gets her own way. But if you just see her now, she'd be charming as anything.
When I told them I was having chemo, Zach asked if my hair would fall out. I said, yes, and it'll look weird at first, but you mustn't be frightened. It won't be forever. He said, I never ever want to be seen with you in public with no hair. I said, I don't blame you. I'll always wear a hat or a scarf. And I did.
Apart from personal history, money and food would be the other main thing. But I would say, pudding, and we'd say, piece of fruit. And then once they're gone, it's out with the dairy milk. Yeah, we lie about that. And about how much margarine it is. We'd say it's less. It's not like kids know how much money's worth anyway. Rich. Just sell the book to the kids. They're gonna have to try. You look at the world now, they're gonna have to really try.
I remember the feel of his hands, small in mine, or the smell off the top of his head, being able to pick him up. When he was a tiny baby, I went to Mother Care on the high street, and he had these sleep suits with the sun, the moon, and the stars on. I thought they were fantastic, so I bought them in all sizes. 3 months, 3 to 6 months, all the way up to 36 months. I went a bit mad, I suppose.
My greatest fear for the future is that if I don't watch it, by the time the last one moves out, the first one will be wanting to be back in. And well, the thought of that keeps me awake at night.
You wore them for years, you can imagine. I can see him in you still.
I don't know how to help her. Make her understand that she's beautiful. Because she really is. It's the hardest thing, I suppose. I look at her and I think, I was beautiful at your age, but I didn't realise it back then.
It's like sand running through hourglass. Towards the end, it looks like it's going faster, but it isn't. And I know that, but still.
It makes you feel totally out of control.
I'm making it sound sad. It isn't. I don't know why it sounds like it is.
I think that's all about saying about sex and so on. Just warn them that the body, the senses, if you like, have a mind of their own and they don't always do what's the best for your long-term future. You won't always feel in control of yourself and more than other people. I said, I'm going to buy some condoms. Just leave them in the bathroom with the Tampax and the rest. They were up in arms about it. David went bonkers at me. He thinks of them as little girls still. I said, I'm not trying to encourage them to do it, but I don't want them to be embarrassed to go out and fight Durex and then, you know. They say, we don't want to discuss sex and drugs and stuff. Just give us a rule. Why can't you be more like grandma? Just tell us. No, you can't do anything, at all, ever. I said, well, you two are the evidence of how well that approach worked.
This year, when his birthday was coming up, I was really hating him. Honestly, really hating him. I couldn't stand the idea of making him a cake. So I have to think to myself, I need to find a way to remember what it was like before, to make him remember what we were like. So I made him a photo album of his life to date, and then I thought, I'm a being me, saying, I know you hate me right now, but look how much I love you with all my cutting and sticking in. And then I thought, you won't think that, you're even being interested. So I did it anyway. And then when his birthday came round, I made him open all his presents, with Kelly there as well. And I saved the album till last. And well, just couldn't stop looking at it. He sat there for hours just looking through the pictures. And I said, there's plenty of room in the back. We'll do this again when you're 18. I'm 21.
I bought some clothes like his. I can't believe I did it.
If I can be, have a row.
I bet I look absolutely ridiculous in them.
Like one of those really vicious ones?
He's been really nice about it.
She'll say, I know I'm only 16, but I don't understand why you don't just force him. Get rid of him before you're too old to get someone else. Honestly, what do you see in him? But of course, this is when you're in a phase of hating the dad. And of course, sometimes the other way around, and I'm the villain.
Fingers. They've got experiment like. They've got to feel like they're doing something that you disapprove of. It's half time, that's the fun of it. You've got to sort of take position. You have to think you're a bit of an old fart.
That's the job.
He knows he was going on holiday with his girlfriend. Her grandma lives in Croatia, near the sea. So I said, hang on, we need to talk about this first and how much is it going to cost? So in the end, we agreed, if he paid half. We set up with so many different jobs, cat feeding, lawn mowing, car washing, all of that. But he didn't really seem interested. I felt riled, I really did, that he didn't put the effort in. So I started nagging, and then it dawned on me. So I talked to him in the car. I said, look, if you don't want to go, it's okay. I'll say I've changed my mind. You're not going. I'll be the bad guy. Silence for miles. I'll just say you're not going. What do you want for tea?
I bought a new dress the other day, and the youngest said, you can't wear that. Not at your age. Don't think of me as 36. Think of me as your age, but 22 years more experience.
She changes so fast. You just get used to one kid, and then 6 weeks later, there's a new kid. New friends, new music taste, new hairstyle.
You worry for him, don't you? But then you worry for the rest of your life.
I suppose the only thing that's worse is if they do all leave and I'll be too knackered to enjoy it. Bloody hell.
The main thing is, they make me laugh. They really, really make me laugh. I can't tell you. I just think they're brilliant. That's the thing in the end. I just think they're great. I really do.
I took Kira to pub for the first time, for a first drink together. She asked for a pint of lager and I bought it her. She didn't finish it. Sick.
Tick,
tock.
Tick,
tock.
Tick,
tock.
Tick, tock.
Minute interval. If you'd like to leave the auditorium while we set up Act 2, there are refreshments available in the foyer area.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.